Well, hello there, peeps of the YouTube. We're going to do a little quick and dirty one. Put in all your dad jokes here again. And this is about adding another Microsoft account to your Windows. Like a work account. So you may ask yourself, why do I want to do that? Well, let's say you have your own personal Microsoft account. That is this machine here that you are logged in on. And then you have like a business account. Like you get a show account from your job that has... all the Office suites are on it, Teams, everything you can dream of without Microsoft that makes it so you can basically do all your work at home. But you don't want to then sign out of your personal account or sign into your business account or, you know, make a user account for your work-related stuff. You can do all of that from one place. But, you know, you have your main account, it's the one you're logged in on, and then you associate your work or school account with this login. So if you go on to, let's say, OneDrive or into an Office suite, you would now have access to all of these things that your school job provided you with. So how do you do that? It's really simple. We go into settings. I like to use this little menu down here. And then you go into your accounts. And you can see here, it always tells you a little bit of stuff about your account in here. But if you go into mail and accounts, now you can see I already have one account here and one account here. So here you can add another Microsoft account, or you can add a workspace or school account. So if you want to add another Microsoft account, let's say you have a Microsoft account for just everyday use, and then you have a Microsoft account for, I don't know, you just want to keep it separate for, you know, productivity, you can use that. But if you want to add a workplace or school account, you just click down here. And then you basically just sign into that account that you want to associate with, or you know, you want to associate with this login here. So if it's a school account, you put in your credentials. If it's a work account, you put in your credentials, and so on and so on. And that means that now if you go into, let's say you go into Teams, if that's down here, you can now use that work or school account with Teams. If you use Outlook, as you can see, I have down here, don't want to open that because mails and shit. Well, your business and work school mails that are being sent to your work school business accounts will be sent to this Outlook account also. Like I said before, if you have Office, do I have that installed? I don't know. Yeah. Let's say that account has the full-blown Office suite because your school or work is paying for it. You can then go up in here and you can then just switch to a different account because it will already be down here because you have associated it with this machine. It's a really amazing thing. Use it a lot at work. A lot at work. And people that work from home use this a lot. You can even add, you know, your account or add an Azure account so it can, your computer can be managed from Azure. All of those amazing things from in here. This is why Microsoft accounts are really, really used a lot in the corporate world, because they can just say, here's your login credentials. That gives you the Office and all of that you need to work, and then you just plug that in as a associated account in here. And you don't have to reinstall anything or make a separate user and blah, 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 blah. You just basically put in the credentials and Bob's your uncle. You can now do everything you would be able to at work, at least if it's a Microsoft associate. I know a lot of people hate Microsoft accounts and yell and scream at it, but from an administrative standpoint and a business standpoint, it's a really fucking great, useful tool. See you all later. Have fun. Enjoy the weekend. Or whenever you see this, enjoy the next day. Bye-bye.